Ever felt tired for no apparent reason? Today we dive into the world of fatigue. Fatigue, often perceived as mere tiredness, is a prevalent and complex condition. It's more than just feeling worn out after a long day. It's a lingering tiredness that is constant and limiting. With fatigue, you have unexplained, persistent, and relapsing exhaustion. Did you know that fatigue is the reason behind a quarter of office visits to family physicians? It's a common concern that peaks between the ages of 20 to 40. Women are 3 to 4 times more likely to report fatigue than men. This could be due to a myriad of factors, including hormonal fluctuations, societal roles, and more. Moreover, half of the people suffering from fatigue have associated psychological complaints or problems. This is particularly true if the fatigue has been persisting for less than 6 months. Still wondering why fatigue is such a big deal? Let's delve into the red flags. Feeling tired all the time can be more than just a sign of a busy life. It can be a symptom of something more serious. When fatigue becomes a persistent issue, it's time to pay attention to the red flags. These may include fever, unexpected weight loss, night sweats, and neurological deficits like difficulty moving or speaking. If someone appears generally ill or unwell, that's another danger sign. Now that you can spot the danger signs, let's explore what conditions fatigue might be hinting at. Fatigue can be a symptom of a wide range of conditions. It's like a puzzle, and a medical detective must piece together the clues to solve it. It might be psychogenic, related to stress or mental health disorders like depression or anxiety. Our sedentary lifestyles can also lead to fatigue, as can certain vascular conditions like stroke. Infections, from the common cold to serious diseases like HIV, are another potential cause. Fatigue could be a sign of neoplastic conditions or cancer, and nutritional deficiencies like anemia. Neurological conditions such as Parkinson's disease or multiple sclerosis can also cause fatigue. Even certain medications can lead to fatigue. Chronic illnesses, autoimmune diseases, toxins, and endocrine disorders are also on the list of potential causes. And sometimes, despite all investigations, fatigue remains idiopathic, meaning we can't pinpoint a specific cause. So we've covered the potential causes. But how do doctors figure out what's causing your fatigue? Investigating fatigue can be a complex process. To uncover the root cause of fatigue, a careful and comprehensive approach is key. Typically, the investigation is guided by a patient's history and physical examination. A patient's history can provide crucial clues. Has the fatigue been sudden or gradual? Is it constant or does it come and go? These questions can help point healthcare professionals in the right direction. Next, a physical examination is conducted. This can help identify any physical signs that might be contributing to fatigue. Following these initial steps, a range of tests may be conducted. These could include complete blood counts, electrolyte tests, and tests for thyroid-stimulating hormone and ferritin. Other tests could involve checking for glucose levels, B12 levels, and even conducting a urinalysis. In some cases, additional tests may be warranted, such as serologies for Lyme disease, hepatitis B and C, HIV, and Mantoux skin tests. Investigations can help pinpoint the cause, but what next? Let's discuss treatment. Once we have a better understanding of the cause, we can move towards treating fatigue. Treatment typically involves addressing the underlying cause. For instance, if fatigue is due to anemia, the approach would be to treat the anemia, which could involve iron supplements or a diet rich in iron. If the fatigue results from a chronic illness, such as heart failure or lung disease, then managing that illness becomes the priority. However, in about 1/3 of patients, the exact cause of fatigue might not be identifiable. In such cases, the approach is more about managing the symptom and improving the quality of life. Reassurance and follow-up are key, especially if the fatigue has a psychogenic etiology, which means it's more related to mental and emotional factors rather than physical ones. Supportive counseling, behavioral therapy, or group therapy can be beneficial. Encouraging the patient to stay physically active can also help maximize function and lessen feelings of fatigue. It's also important to review all medications, over-the-counter drugs, and herbal remedies that the patient is taking to check for potential drug-drug interactions and side effects that could be contributing to the fatigue. The prognosis is generally good. After a year, around 40% of patients report that they no longer feel fatigued. Remember, fatigue is a symptom, not a disease. It's crucial to identify and address the root cause for effective treatment. Thank you for staying with us. If you found this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and support our channel. We have a variety of videos on our channel, Medicine Health 360, that cover a wide range of health topics, From understanding the causes of common symptoms to exploring the latest medical breakthroughs, we aim to bring you the most up-to-date, comprehensive health knowledge in a simple and easy-to-understand format. Subscribing to our channel not only supports us, but it also ensures that you don't miss out on any crucial health information. By strengthening your understanding of health and medicine, you can take control of your own well-being. So join our community today for better health and a better life. Remember, knowledge is power, and in this case, it can also be the key to a healthier, happier you. Stay tuned for more, and remember, we're here to help you navigate your health journey. Thank you for watching.